Quantum computing is extremely exciting at the moment. It's a very rapidly developing field. The technology is accelerating ahead at an incredible pace.
One of the factors that limits industry adoption of quantum computing is the fact that there are a limited number of algorithms that are known.
You have to have good tools for actually interfacing with quantum computing.
There are tens of millions of software developers, but less than 1,000 quantum computing specialists worldwide.
At Horizon, we're trying to bridge the gap between conventional software developers and quantum computing hardware. We've been building up a system that automatically translates conventional computer code into something that can run on a quantum processor.
Basically, you take the source code and run it through a compiler. It first recognizes where there can be some speedups, usually around features such as loops. A compiler can, for example, accelerate loops, breaking large loops apart into simpler elements. It does this by using a variety of techniques which allow the contents of a loop to be broken into independent parts. The simple elements produced by this loop splitting procedure are then classified and replaced with more efficient quantum procedures. Quantum algorithms produced in this are then compiled down into an optimized list of instructions native to the target quantum computer.
But reliability is an issue. Most of the operations that you would see coming out of state-of-the-art groups, and that's commercial or academic, work about 99% of the time. And if you have a failure rate of 1%, that can mean you have, right? So for millions of operations, suppose there's 10 million, that means there's 100,000 failed operations sprinkled throughout your algorithm somewhere. Very few algorithms can survive that kind of abuse.
Every complex problem, every innovation is built out of little building blocks. So you always break your problem down and you always try the little cases. And then you sort of build the thing back up again.
So we're working on some circuit simplification techniques that will take some arbitrary operation that a client might demand, express it using a quantum circuit, and then see whether they can be reduced to simpler operations at multiple stages through the compiler.
It's actually pretty amazing, to be honest, to watch something actually run and work.
Getting it is exciting. Like when the puzzle sort of snaps into place, you go, aha.
I first met Joe when he was giving a talk at the weekly Friday Hacks meeting at NUS. He mentioned that quantum computing today is just like the way computing was back in the early 1950s and 1960s. And I think that really made me interested in what he was doing, because my overall goal is to be working at the forefront of technological progress.
We're going through this transition, and whether it succeeds or fails is really on us. It's on all of the people in the field contributing to the effort right now. That really should be motivation for anyone. We're making it possible for any software developer out there to take advantage of quantum computing hardware. And that really opens up endless possibilities.